Patrick. I ran the number 5 seat for the University of Johannesburg, and we competed today in the 2 races against Oxford University.
Gentlemen, just tell us a bit about your background in the Olympics and cycling.
I went to Beijing 2008 Paralympic Games, where I raced in tandem, track tandem cycling, and I was fortunate enough to win a bronze medal.
Okay, and how did you end up rowing?
I took a year off after the cycling that I did. I just had a little bit of a burnout and I wanted to change to a different sport, something new. And I was offered a scholarship to go to University of Johannesburg. And yeah, I just made it into the national team from there.
Great. Is this your first time rowing in the Dunedin area?
Yes. I've been here before. When I was young, I've visited Dunedin, but it's the first time I've ever come here.
And then on the Olympic side, when you won the medal 2008, what was the feeling?
It's a very strange feeling, right? Especially when you're a small country like South Africa going into the Olympics, you're kind of seen as an underdog. And I think my most proud moments of the whole thing and actually winning the medal and that was when I stood on the podium and they raised the flags and I actually saw the South African flag being raised before the others, and I knew then that that I'd made it to the big time and actually achieved something that a lot of people don't actually get to or won't achieve in a lifetime.
Okay, so you're now part of the able-bodied rowing team. So what are you hoping for in the rowing sport?
I actually narrowly missed out going to London Paralympics this year. We missed qualification by like 0.03 of a second.
Okay.
So, you know, because I'm under the UJ banner, I filtered into the able-bodied A crew rowing, you know, the system. And I was fortunate enough to be one of the first adapters for disabled rowers to row in the university boat race. And on top of that, we won a medal as well at the boat race. So it's actually showing that we've been done before.
Okay, cool. So what do you think of the rowing conditions here in Dunedin?
Oh, they're perfect. I know the national team come here quite often on training camps, long training camps. And the water is amazing, the facility where we stay is amazing, and it's just getting out of Johannesburg away from the fast-paced lifestyle and stuff, you can focus on what you have to do and actually do the training and the racing that you need to get done.
So what do you think of the competition today at Oxford?
Well, they're kind of our heroes, you know, every year we have a little competition in both races and it's tough racing for us, and we watch them on TV.
Yeah.
And they, a lot of the guys that are in both the Oxford and the Cambridge crew are Olympians, or they've been to the Olympics or whatever, and we look up to them. So for them to come here and interact with us, it really has been special, and to chat to them, we actually have learned a lot, and I think going forward we will be able to be more confident and we'll have stories to tell other people, which is really amazing.
Okay, great. Have you visited any local tourism chapters?
Yes, we went up to the waterfall yesterday in the Finnish Cure.
Okay.
Like I said, when I was younger, I stayed in the area and I used to go there quite a lot, so it was amazing to go back and to see it again, because it's actually a very special place in my heart and I've always wanted to come back, so it was a treat to come back. And then we tried to go to the big oak tree today, but it was closed, unfortunately.
Oh, geez. So when did you stay here? What was that time?
I was very young. I was about between the age of 7 and 10, and we stayed in Petersburg, and we all used to just come up this way on the weekends to explore and see the area, actually.
How does the rowing conditions compare to where you usually row?
The in Joburg where we stay, we've got a very small lake, you know, so it feels like you're rowing around in a fishbowl.
Where's that?
At Germiston Lake, down in the south of Joburg. But we also train in Pretoria, which is the rowing center for South African rowing. But because it's so far, you know, it takes us about an hour to get to the training facility. So, you know, going to somewhere like this where it's a nice long course, the water's flat, you can focus on things that you can try to instill into your teaching, and the conditions lend themselves to a really good training.
Okay, would you like to come back to the area to use it?
Most definitely. I'm really hoping it's become the UK Oxford tradition for the next couple of years. I know they've been to Zambia a few times. But it was a great opportunity for us, and I think it's something for people to look forward to going to UK itself and start growing on it, because it is actually a reward to come and be part of the club after having such amazing growth.
My last question, what would be the next big race for you?
I've kind of finished the university season now. We've got one more regatta coming up at the end of October. And then from the end of November, I go back to the time of the national team training. And through the course of next year, we'll be visiting Italy. We'll go to the Eastern course where they race for Olympics this year. And then World Championships. Those are the goals for next year, but the bigger thing.